That's the church I pastor, and I'm still a member there, so I will not vote on this one.
That's fine. Good afternoon, everyone. This is Assiniboine Community Committee. Today is Tuesday, December 5th. I'm the chairperson today, and my name is Councillor Dobson. We have with us Councillor Gillingham and Councillor Morantz, and we have our clerk, Mrs. Cohen, and we have, from the planning department, we have Mr. Clark and Mr. Hare. Our first, before I go any further, could I have someone move the minutes of the previous meeting?
I so move.
Okay.
Aye.
Okay. Okay, confirmed. Thank you. The first report is the citizen member appointments, the Assiniboine Library Advisory Committee. The Assiniboine Community Committee has received four applications for appointment to the Assiniboine Library Advisory Committee for vacancy as follows. Three citizens for a two-year term to expire December 31st, 2019. One citizen for the balance of a two-year term to expire on December 31st. Have we received any?
Mr. Chair, I don't see the names.
Yeah, I don't see any names either.
I sent them in an email. I can resend it to you.
Oh, thank you.
No problem.
Thank you. We should pay closer attention. You did send them. Okay.
Just 1 second while we get all the names together here.
I'm not logged in for my office. Okay, hold on.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Mr. Chair, just a question. Given that this is in your ward, I mean, I'd be glad to move this, or if you want to pass the chair, that's fine too. Whatever your preference is.
Sure. Okay. I'll pass the chair.
Okay. Sure. Okay. Entertain a motion then to bring these names forward for the following appointments. I guess looking for three of these individuals to serve in a two-year term and then one of the individuals to serve the balance of the two-year term. As you wish.
Yeah. So moved.
Okay. Is there one particular Councillor Dobson you'd like to see as be the one that serves the balance of the two-year term, which expires next year? One of the four names?
I have no preference at this point.
Okay. They can always be reappointed in due course, too, right? These individuals, Madam Clerk?
I think we would need to indicate which ones are for the two-year term and which are for the term to expire at the end of next year.
Okay.
All right, and then let's go with the first name, Joseph Robert Hardy.
Okay, so Mr. Hardy would serve as the citizen for the balance of the two-year term expiring December 31st, 2018. The other three individuals then would serve as for two-year terms expiring December 31st, 2019.
Okay. So moved.
Okay.
Just a quick question on the fourth name. It says, please note there are two submitted applications for this individual. What does that mean?
He had just submitted two separate applications for the same committee. I'm not sure if it was by error.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. All in favor?
Just to clarify. So the three citizens for a two-year term to expire December 31st, 2019 are Sean Moore, Leslie Lewis, and Thomas Silver. Sorry. And then the one citizen for the balance of a two-year term to expire December 31st, 2018, Joseph Hardy.
Okay. I believe so. Was that your intention?
Yeah, that's the intention.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried. I'll turn the chair back over to...
Okay.
And I'll recuse myself.
Okay, we have a per capita grant, Grace Community Church, West Grove Learning Center.
Yes, Mr. Chair. Ms. Kellen, I don't know if you have the number, the balance of my... You don't happen to have the balance of my per capita grant account, do you?
$1,112.75.
Okay, I know the application is for $500, but I would like to actually amend this grant to be $712.75.
Okay.
And it's for the West Grove Learning Center. The money is donated through the Grace Church, though. And the West Grove Learning Center provides English as a second language services to new Canadians and new immigrants in my ward. So I'd like to move that we approve that per capita grant for $712.75.
Okay, we have the motion. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Okay. Yeah. Mr. Chair. Oh, it's back.
Okay, item number three.
This is a grant to the White Ridge Community Center to support the annual White Ridge Winter Carnival in the amount of $400. I'd like to move this grant forward.
That's the motion?
Yeah.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried. This next one is a per capita grant in Assiniboine Community Center. Could I pass the chair, please?
I will take the chair.
Okay. This is for the Assiniboine Community Centers Board, and I would like to, they've asked for a total grant requested of $900. The amount received in prior years was $750. I would like to give them $300 from the St. Charles Ward.
Okay. The motion is a $300 per capita grant to assist with the cost of volunteer appreciation at the Assiniboia Community Centers Board, correct?
That's correct.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried. Ask the chair. How do you want me to keep the chair?
Keep the chair, please.
Keep the chair.
Item number five is a per capita grant, Equal Opportunities West. They have submitted a per capita grant for the amount of $2,000. This group is basically works with disabled adults. They've been in our area for upwards of 20 years or longer. And they've been in the news, unfortunately, quite a bit. And this is to assist in their Christmas party. So I would like to give them a per capita grant of the amount of $1,500 to assist in their Christmas party. That's my motion.
Okay, motion on the floor for a $1,500 grant to Equal Opportunities West to assist with the cost of their Christmas party. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Carried. I will...
This is
take you the chair. Pass the chair.
This is mine again.
So I'll keep
item,
the chair.
Item number six, land dedication reserve fund, St. James Assiniboia Minor Hockey Association. Okay. This is the Allard Arena parking lot resurfacing. The actual parking lot is showing a lot of wear and tear, and they're looking at doing a little bit of resurfacing, especially for where the garbage trucks enter and exit, because it is causing a lot of wear and tear. So they're asking for $20,232.71 from land dedication reserve fund. And that's, I would like to give that to them. That's my motion.
Just one question on that. I think I'm generally supportive. I'm just, do we know, I guess, the status of the Allard Arena? I haven't heard that, you know, it's anything but that it's going to continue operating, right? I don't.
It's fine. It's going to run until its ice plant fails, and that could be 10, 20 years down the road. Yep. It's in really good shape.
Yeah. No, I know that I was also speaking to one of the gentlemen that's gives leadership there, and he said he was bringing this forward through Councilor Dobbs. So I'm glad to support it as well, and so I have no reservations on this.
Looks like the department is recommending approval, subject to looks like the usual conditions.
Yeah.
So again, so the motion is then to approve this
$20,232.71.
$20,232.71. As a land dedication reserve to be utilized in accordance with item number 6. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Carried. Next is a planning approval.
I can take the chair back.
Plan approval. Okay, I'll pass the chair.
Yes. Okay.
Thank you.
Item number 7, plan approval, 700 Sterling Lion Parkway, with Tuxedo White Ridge Ward.
Oh, I was just here for the grand opening.
Oh, no, this is the Hyatt. Sorry, it's on the wrong place. This is the Hyatt.
Yeah, Hyatt.
Okay. Just with planners, if I may. I remember we talked about this quite some time ago. I thought we had a plan approval. I remember it was brought with some urgency at the time on the basis that the proponents needed plan approval to close their land deal, as I recall. How long ago was that?
That was on May 9th, 2017, that the previous plans were approved.
So why are we having a new plan approval?
We understand that the applicants changed their architect, and there was a few outstanding items on the previous plan that they needed to address. Those plans that were approved, they were subject to 4 conditions. They still had a alternative equivalency compliance that they required for insufficient landscaping. They still didn't have final landscaping plans. And there was also conditions for them to include a tabletop style pathway connecting the AT pathway on Sterling Line to the front of the building and an ornamental fence along the front yard. So the applicants changed the architect and refined their plans including addressing these conditions that were placed on the previous one. So overall, the new plans that are coming forward are generally consistent with what was previously approved, other than a few small details, including addressing those 4 conditions.
My recollection is that there, at the time, the major issue or concern was this idea that there'd be parking right up against Sterling Lion Parkway. Has that changed, or is that still the same?
That's still the same.
So the parking is still, and we had sort of acquiesced in that at the time on the basis that they were doing some, was it the landscaping, or what was
the? They were adding the ornamental fence along the front yard, as well as doing a tabletop pathway connection.
Okay. And there's something with the parking too, the number of stalls, wasn't there?
Yes, they were over on parking, and they still are over on the parking. In the previous version of the plan, they had 130 stalls, and they've reduced about 4 stalls. Basically, they've gotten rid of all of the parallel parking stalls, so that all parking spaces are now at 90-degree angles.
Okay, so otherwise, you guys are satisfied with the plan?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Cool. Looks fine to me. I'll move that we approve this plan for the Hyatt Hotel. It's nice to see some hotels going up in the ward. I was just at the opening of the Hilton. It's a beautiful hotel, and I'm sure this one will be very, very nice as well. And a lot of exciting stuff happening in the area, that's for sure. So, I'll move that we approve the plan for the Hyatt House.
Motion's on the table. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Can we do that? Yeah, we can do that now.
Mr. Chair.
I thought there was another plan approval.
We have some new business, yeah.
If Do you have new business first, and then I'll do this one, or can I do this one now?
Sure, we can do that one because it's recent.
Okay, Mr. Chair, I wonder if I could move that we rescind your motion from item number 4, and I'll explain why. Because when I look back, I had Ms. Cohen look back at our last year, this grant application to provide a forum for discussion and sharing experiences, coordination of issues related to finances, facilities, mm-hmm. programs, the Assiniboine Community Centers, all of us participated last year. And so I'd be willing to add to. I think, did you say $250? Is that what you said?
I gave $300.
$300? I think I could afford $250, so that would make $550.
Can we back up?
So can we rescind the motion? Or?
Well, just to be clear, I've now utilized all of my...
Yes, you have.
Yeah. ...capital grants.
We understand that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So would it be a motion to rescind, or would you have to...
We can rescind the motion, yeah.
Okay.
Sure.
Okay. Yes, my motion. I will rescind the motion to give $300 to the Assiniboia Community Centers Board.
We have to vote on the motion to rescind. I guess we do. All in favor?
Aye.
Carried. Okay. A new motion.
Okay. The per capita grant for Assiniboia Community Centers.
I'll send it all back to you. So the total of that we approve a total of $550, $250 coming from St. James Brooklyn's Weston Ward and $300 from the St. Charles Ward.
Okay, there's a motion on the table. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Seamless.
Works good. Okay, we have new business.
We also have a plan approval that I'll walk on. Not sure which order we want to go in.
The plan approval is in your folders. Do you want to deal with that one first?
That's fine. I also have a motion I'd like to bring forward in the Assiniboine Community Committee. I can let you have a look at it before I do it.
Sure. Why don't we deal with the plan approval?
Okay.
And then we can look at the motion. So this is in my ward. I don't really see a plan. Oh, sorry.
Did we need approval to walk it on?
I move to suspend the rules.
All in favor?
Aye. So this is the Tuxedo Park Shopping Center, correct?
Correct.
And this is, what is it?
Oh, Shoppers.
Those Shoppers are present.
Any concerns about this?
Not at all. Minor alteration of the exterior finish and creation of new doors or replacement of old doors, and ultimately that was required for the community committee plan approval, but there's no concerns at all. It's all part of the upgrades that are going on.
I'll move approval of this plan for the Tuxedo Park Shopping Center or Shoppers or MERT. Plan.
Motion's on the table. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Okay.
Okay, I have a motion I'd like to walk on. And I will tell you the motion first. Whereas there's a tremendous local opposition to the development of a proposed opioid addiction treatment center at 255 Hamilton Avenue, and whereas the local residents want 255 Hamilton Avenue to continue at its that it is currently zoned PR2 Parks and Recreation Active Neighborhood Community, and whereas many organizations have shown interest in the lands located at 255 Hamilton Avenue, therefore it be resolved that the Standing Policy Committee on Property Development, Heritage and Downtown be requested to direct the Winnipeg Public Service to issue an expression of interest for the lands at 255 Hamilton Avenue, the Vimy Arena site.
Sorry, just need a motion to
suspend. Okay.
Suspend the rules here. Are you chair right now?
I'm currently the chair. I can pass the chair. I can't actually put the motion.
We want to suspend the rules.
You can.
What? Well, yeah. Well, I'll move to suspend the rules.
Okay.
Okay. All those in favor?
Of suspending the rules.
Of suspending the rules.
Okay. Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Carried.
So who's going to be able to pass the chair to somebody?
Okay, well, who wants to take the chair?
Sure.
Okay.
I'll take the chair. Let me just read the motion again.
I know.
Yes.
I could read it out if you'd like.
No, that's okay. Okay. Okay, so should I read the motion out again?
Sure.
Okay. So the motion proposed by a councillor is, whereas there is tremendous local opposition to the development of the proposed opioid addiction treatment center at 255 Hamilton Avenue, Vimy Arena site, and whereas the local residents want 255 Hamilton Avenue to continue as it is currently zoned, PR2 Parks and Recreation, active neighborhood community, and whereas many organizations have shown interest in the land located at 255 Hamilton, therefore be resolved that the Standing Policy Committee on Property and Development, Heritage and Downtown Development be requested to direct the Winnipeg Public Service to issue an expression of interest for the land at 255 Hamilton Avenue, Vimy Arena site. Questions, comments, discussion?
Well, the most discussion I have on that is that we will find what best fits the land by doing this. What's the best fit for the neighborhood, for that site? And that's the reason why you put an expression of interest out there. We can find it. What's viable? Who wants to develop on that site? If it's a sports group that wants to go in there, the only way we're going to find out is put an expression of interest out there.
Thank you, Mr. Acting Chair. I appreciate my colleagues' efforts with the community. I won't be supporting his motion, the motion that's on the table, for a couple of reasons. I think that in the same way, much the same way that, there's much talk of opposition, and there's much opposition that's been expressed. There's much support that's been expressed as well. A lot of support, a lot of opposition, a lot of support. As I understand it, and I don't know all the details, but there is a process currently underway. I understand the department is currently, looking at this matter, and I think it'd be important to let the process that's underway unfold currently. I understand that process is coming through the Property and Development Committee, and so I think it would be premature at this point to prescribe what the department does, because this process is underway, and I think that there's opportunity in due course to respond to what the department brings forward. So I won't be supporting this motion at this point.
I also respectfully to the councillor will not be supporting the motion, but I for another reason in addition to that one, which is that there is a process that the city has for how land is used. It's the rezoning and variance process. We're going to be having a hearing here shortly, which is an example of that. We go through that all the time, and I think at the end of the day, no matter who has the land, there's going to have to be a development application, which is going to be vetted by the planning department, and they'll come forward and either they'll recommend for or against, or with conditions or without conditions. And until we have that in front of us, until we know what any development application might look like, we aren't really in a position to really decide what the land use might be. In addition to that, my understanding is that there is an exception for the expressions of interest where the province has made a request, and I'm not completely familiar with the provisions, and so without having that information, it's hard for me to sort of try and direct the Property and Development Committee on one path or another. So those are basically my reasons. But I do respect the fact that you put forward the motion, and I know you're fighting for your community. So
and I respect your answers, but I feel they're both wrong, as any property should either be put up for the sale on the private market, and or an expression of interest or a request for proposal should have been done. Going through the province and intentionally going through the province and giving it to a developer, he is circumventing our rules, and I feel that is totally wrong. If we were to give it to the province without knowing what the province was going to do, without the intention of the province giving it to a private developer and knowing it, that would be fine. But we already know the intention. It's been stated a number of times. So I stand by my convictions that this is the proper way to go.
Are we able to get a copy of your motion? It's possible. Can you? Okay, I appreciate that. Good.
Okay.
So the motion's on the table.
Okay, any further questions? Okay, so I will call a question on the motion. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, I would like to be recorded in opposition to the motion.
Likewise.
Okay, thank you.
We're good. Thank you.
I got the last copy.
Okay. Thank you.
Save you one.
Okay.
Okay, we're just let me get out of here.
14.
And we're going into hearings right away. Okay, we're going to call the meeting to order. This is the hearings portion of the Assiniboine Community Committee. I don't think I have to introduce everybody again.
Okay. All persons who wish to speak or receive notice of the hearing body's decision or recommendation must fill out a public representation form and submit it to me as soon as possible. Copies of this form can be found at the registration table outside of the room. In accordance with the City of Winnipeg Charter and the Development Procedures Bylaw, the process the committee will follow is that the applicant will be heard first, followed by those in support of the application. Next, those registered in opposition are heard, followed by those registered for information. Finally, the applicant may return to speak in rebuttal to comments made, however, no new information is permitted. Please note that when your name is called, it is your opportunity to speak. However, you are not obligated to do so. This is the public hearing process brochure, copies of which are available at the registration table. The brochure contains an overview of the process and other information pertaining to what happens before, during, and after a public hearing. As information, all public hearings are recorded and will be part of the public record. Should you have any questions after the public hearing has concluded, please contact the City Clerk's Department. Item 1 is a variance at 1476 Portage Avenue under file DAV171509 of 2017.
Okay. Ron Chan. You're welcome to come and speak. You have 10 minutes. Could you just state your name and address, please?
Just sit at the floor.
Yep.
My name is Ron Chan, project coordinator for Winnipeg Regional Health Authority. I'm representing the owner of this piece of property today at 1476 Portage Avenue.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman, do you mind just explaining maybe the highlights of what this application is?
Yeah, like I mentioned, we are the owner of this property. It's a church on 3.3 acres. Several years ago, we began the process of looking at purchasing this church with the intent of demolishing and hopefully building a personal care home on the site. With the change in government, as everyone knows, the appetite for proceeding with this project was not received. It was the previous government that championed the purchase of this building and the building of the PCH. But the full intent is still to build on this land. We own it. But in the meantime, it has been sitting vacant, and we've been babysitting it, so to speak, under the vacant building bylaw. But now there's an opportunity for a tenant, music school. But in order for them to occupy the premise, we have to rezone or have a variance.
So the variance that's before us here basically would allow for a temporary change of use, so that rather than the building, if I understand it right, rather than the building, the church sit dormant and sit empty, that it could be used for up to 3 years to put a music school in there that could use the building, access the building, and generate maybe a bit of revenue, or you know, for a WRHA. Is that the gist of what we're looking
at? Yes, that's correct.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Are there any are those residences
next door?
Yeah. Next door? Any? Can I ask a question of the planner? Oh, any issues with noise from music school or anything like that?
Not that we're aware of.
Outside speakers? I'm not sure.
I don't believe so. We didn't hear about any.
I only ask because I've had that come up in my ward. So.
Okay. No, with the application, they did have some signatures, several signatures from residents in the Dawnwood Manor, as well as support from the other as well as the other adjacent businesses saying they were in support of the change of use.
Okay.
Well, that's. I have no further questions.
No.
That's it. Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, Charles Biggs, would you like to speak?
I really don't have much to say.
Okay. Maxine Castia? If I spelt it wrong, or said it wrong, I'm sorry. Okay, could you just state your name and address, and you have 10 minutes.
Maxine Kessler, and I live at 1460 Portage Avenue. Right across my living room actually looks over onto the church where the music school is.
And you're in support of it?
I'm in support, yes.
Okay, great.
It's much better than having the building empty, and I haven't noticed there has been no noise. There's been no problem with our parking. There's been absolutely no problem. The residents in my building are pretty much thrilled to have them there.
Music lessons, I take it?
Yes, yes. Several people are taking music lessons.
Perfect. Thank you.
Thank you for appearing. I know that there's certainly an advantage to having activity at a building rather than be next door to a quote-unquote abandoned building, which can lead to all sorts of challenges, so I can appreciate that.
Yes, yes, we appreciate having them there.
Okay, Riley L. Okay, thank you. Jim Langdon?
No, thank you.
Okay, thank you. Julie Biggs?
Hi there, my name is Julie Biggs, and I live at 302 Nightingale Road. I'm the director of the Winnipeg Conservatory of Music, and I guess co-applicant with Ron. And we spoke to all of the people surrounding us, and everyone is in high support of this. It's a nice enhancement to the community.
Okay. Go ahead.
Thank you. As the area councillor, I want to thank you, first of all, for you've done the due diligence that doesn't always happen. I mean, you went out of your way to speak to the residents and explain to them, you know, what you're looking to do and the type of school that you're going to run. And I think that goes a long way. when individuals reach out to the community around them to get buy-in and clear communication, it preemptively solves a lot of potential challenges. So thank you. I'm just wondering, what are the hours of your school in the day? Is it a Monday to Friday, or is it?
It's pretty quiet until after school, mm-hmm. and then it's just one-on-one lessons for most of the hours that we're there. So we have three large classrooms. So there'll be one teacher in each classroom teaching one student at a time.
Okay.
So there isn't a lot of car volume, mm-hmm. And it's on a major bus route too, so we have several busers. And then once a week we have an adult choir. In the evening there are about 25, and again they carpool. Not really much of an impact on the neighborhood, aside from having an open door policy, so we're getting a lot of visitors, and several residents from next door are now taking lessons. So,
oh, excellent.
Yeah, it's a really nice community,
yep.
And I think it enhances the location.
That's good.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is separate from, but just as an aside, if our budget does pass, or when it does pass, the rest of the Empress work will be done, so your school, all the residents may see some construction in the area this coming year, but just thanks again for your efforts to
thank you
to work with the community on this.
Thanks very much.
Okay, thank you. Pat Laco, I'm guessing. Did
oh,
I get it right?
Very good. Never happens. Well, my great child, math teacher, but
you're not him. Yeah, so I am Pat Laco,
yeah.
And I live at 480 Craig Street. It's about two blocks from the school. I've been attending the school now for several years. I'm part of the choir. That's why there's so many blue shirts. We have a choir performance tonight. I just want to say that I've lived in that neighborhood for a long time. The building has been empty for a long time. I've seen changes in my neighborhood, in my Omens Creek Park, and I can see when we got to the school how that's moved over there too. And I see us as a presence there. I'm in a small theory class where we have two of the residents from the condo in our class. They truly appreciate our presence there. And I like being able to be in a building that for our music school we shared and rented space with another tenant, and to have the school just for the school and not have to share space, it's nice. It's really nice. I think it's an asset to the community to have the caliber of school so close, especially to my home, two blocks. I can walk there, and I hope that the variance zoning variance passes. So that's all I have
Thank
to
you.
Say.
Thank you.
You.
Gerald Bliff.
Oh, you got it.
That's two for two.
Hi, I'm Jerry Bly. I live at 480 Craig Street, the same place as Pat. We're married, and we enjoy going to the school together. I just feel so invigorated when I go in there. You know, it's just a marvelous place, and a lot of work we put into it, and cleaning up all, just making the building respectable again, and on a special, such a major artery as, a lot of people see it, and wow, it's really looking a lot better. So it enhances the neighborhood, and like Pat was saying, I'm in the music theory class too, and the two ladies really enjoyed it, and they're older too, and so, it's nice. So music is good. Thank you very much. I support
thank
it.
Thank you. Barclay Engel.
I think I'm okay, thanks.
Okay, all right. Bonnie Wallace.
I think it's been said.
All right. Any guesses?
Nice to
see
you.
Is it blessing?
Yes, please.
Okay.
Okay, great. Linda McFadden?
I'm supportive.
Okay, great. And one more. Montana?
I'm in support as well.
Oh, great. Okay, is there anyone whose name has not been called who wishes to speak in support? Okay. Is there anyone whose name has not been called who wishes to speak in opposition? Is there anyone here whose name has not been called for information only?
Okay.
Yeah, Fred Coe, R-E-D-C-O-E.
Okay.
Oh,
in support.
We missed, sorry. All right.
We can
do
yeah.
Okay. But I think that's it for me.
Clerk has indicated we can get you folks registered after. Yeah.
I'll come over after the meeting if you. Yeah, we can fill it out.
All right. Do I have a motion to approve this variance?
Do I'd be glad to do that before I do. Had we known that we had acquired the room, Mr. Chair, we could have gotten them to sing their presentation.
Well, we could have brought some. You know, we could,
yeah, exactly. So, yeah. Anyway, so I would. I would, Mr. Chair, then I'd move that the report of the Winnipeg Public Service be taken as read.
Just one second while I get to that. I'm a little bit lost here. Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed, carried.
I move the receipt of the public representations be concluded.
In favor? Opposed, aye. Carried.
And I move that in accordance with subsection 247.3 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, the variance is consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any applicable secondary plan, does not create a substantial adverse effect on the amenities, use, safety, and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including an area separated from the property by street or waterway, is the minimum modification of a zoning bylaw required to relieve the injurious effect of the zoning bylaw on the applicant's property, and is compatible with the area in which the property to be affected is situated. My supporting comments on that is that this is a good use of the building that is currently vacant. I commend the representatives from the Winnipeg Conservatory of Music for their efforts to reach out to and consult with the adjacent members of the community. I see that this is a variance that could be in effect for up to 3 years, if I've got that right. So concurring also with the recommendation of our planning department in this regard. And so those are my supporting comments.
No comments? Okay, all those support?
Aye.
Opposed, carried.
And I move that the recommendation of the Winnipeg Public Service be concurred in and the variance be approved.
All those in support?
Aye.
Opposed, carried.
And I move that the public hearing with respect to this application be concluded.
All those in support?
Aye.
Opposed, carried.
Good.
Please note that the committee's decision with respect to this application may be appealed. Should you wish to appeal, information on how to do so will be included in the order issued, which will be mailed to all persons registered.
Just for fun, Mr. Chair, there is a line here that says that it's a minimum modification of the bylaw to relieve the injurious effect of the zoning bylaw. Well, the injurious effect, we haven't heard the choir, but we believe that there'd be no injurious effect. Confidence, a good choir.
Eh?
Yeah. So.
Hey? Okay, who's going to adjourn?
I'll move adjournment.
Okay. Sure. Meeting's adjourned.
Okay.
Right.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Priceless. Priceless. Priceless.